data is everywhere. Sports games, weather forecasts, stock prices, medical records. Data in the wild comes in a variety of qualities, and many things can be misleading. Numbers stored as strings, NANDs stored as numbers, corrupted string encodings, missing labels. Once the data is in the computer and cleaned up, there are still considerations to be made whether the form is appropriate. The concept of tidy data was introduced by Hadley Wickham to describe data in which each column represents a variable and each row represents an observation. Having a cleaned, tidy dataset makes running analysis much nicer, but it takes work to get there. The messy, unstructured sources of data reflect the messy, unstructured world they come from. This shouldn't be discouraging, though. There is so much to be discovered. It is a beautiful soup of information and insight. Once you've managed to wrangle your data into the computer and tidy it up, then the visualization process in Altair can begin. Altair has four data types which it can visualize. Quantitative variables are probably the most common and familiar data type. They are defined as continuous real-valued quantities. Essentially, they are the numbers that are measured. The exact temperature in the room, how much money you saved this year, the atomic mass of hydrogen, all these values are quantitative measures. Ordinal variables are defined as discrete ordered quantities. They are essentially labels that have an intrinsic order. Labeling items by size, such as small, medium, and large, or describing the temperature in the room as hot and cold are examples of ordinal variables. A quantitative measure, like a person's age, can be grouped to create an ordinal variable such as age range. Nominal variables are simply categorical labels. They are defined as discrete, unordered categories. Labels such as people's names or types of animals are all nominal variables. Note the only comparison that can be made between nominal variables is if they are equal or not. Otherwise, there is no intrinsic order or difference which can be calculated. Finally, Altair also has a special data type for temporal variables. They are simply any date or time values. Temporal variables are similar to quantitative variables, but have a few special operations. You can create interesting visualizations by grouping by days of the week, by month, or year. Altair also defines a fifth data type for geographic objects, which I am not covering in this video. To further explore these concepts, let's build up a visualization that uses one of each data type. For this example, we will use a dataset containing a variety of statistics on cars. Let's say we are interested in how horsepower has changed over time. We will map the X position to the year variable and the Y position to horsepower. Altair will try to infer the data type based on the variables, but it's best practice to include a shorthand in the encoding as such. In this case, T and Q stand for temporal and quantitative, respectively. Let's further map the color of each point to the number of cylinders. Note that if no encoding shorthand is used, Altair assumes that cylinders are a quantitative variable because it's recorded as a number. In this context, the number of cylinders is better defined as an ordinal variable labeling the class of engine. Notice that Altair automatically changes the legend based on the data types. To finish up this example, we will add another encoding with a nominal variable. Here we map the chart column to the country of origin. Altair takes care of the appropriate legends and labels so that we can focus on the analysis. Here we see that this dataset contains many older cars from the US with high horsepower. Knowing this could influence how we later perform statistical tests. One of the things I enjoy most about Altair is how it rewards me for engaging with the visualization process. Instead of picking a chart from a list of available templates, I am encouraged to dream up my own new and interesting ways to build a visualization. The developers of Altair, Vega, and Vega-Lite have created tools that implement the best practices in visualization based on years of research. Best of all, it's open source and free to use. I've included some links in the description to a few written tutorials as well as the project documentation. Grab some data, make some plots, and most importantly, have fun.